Meru.
Well, good morning, Mike. 9 constituencies in Meru County. We are currently at Imenti North constituency, where we expect the presidential results for the constituency, the final tally from the returning officer. And of course, these results, unlike in what we have experienced in the past, will be sent to the National Tallying Center, the constituency being the final station where we expect the presidential results before the national returning officer for the presidential election can announce a winner. And on our way to the Tallying Center, we chanced upon a Commissioner of the National Cohesion and Integration Commission, Professor Gitile Naituli. And Professor, this is an interesting experience for Kenya. We have, less than 50% of Kenyans turn out to vote. The larger percentage did not participate in the exercise, but we have a country to build after. What's the way forward?
I think the most important thing is the electioneering period is now behind us. We will have our president. And then it is now the responsibility of the national leadership and the county leadership, because remember we have two governments. We have national government and the county government to embark on uniting the people of Kenya, because it will be their responsibility now so that we can have one country. So after the government is established, you would expect that the leaders are going to reach out so that they can put this country together. But, you know, people have really done well. They have exercised their right to vote, and those other Kenyans have also exercised their right not to vote, which is respected because that is the constitution, that is our laws. And so now when the government is formed, it will be the government of the people of Kenya. And that government now will embark on the process of uniting all of us.
But the assumption among a majority of these supporters of the opposition that did not turn out to vote is that the consultation that you're talking about never happened in time, and they feel left out of a very critical chance for them to make a decision about the future of this country. What's the way forward? Because we could be headed back to the Supreme Court on one level. We could be headed to more division in the future. Their complaint as a people that never participated in the exercise, you would say, is legitimate.
I think the division will be overcome. They will definitely be overcome, because we also realize that we must move forward as a country and look into the future, not in the past. So these interventions which are created by the electioneering period will be overcome. Those who did not participate, there will be serious effort to include them, because the government is a government of the people of Kenya. The government that emerges now will be a government of the people of Kenya. So the effort to reach out will be there and to include, so that there is inclusiveness, so that we all feel that we belong here and we are Kenyans. That will happen. The emotions of the election and all that, they will go down. They are not going to remain the same. You realize the country has taken a beating economically, psychologically, and even our international reputation has also been damaged. All that, there will be real work to repair all that, so that we can feel that we are together in this republic of ours, and that we improve the future for our children and our grandchildren.
But Professor, there's a question about legitimacy here. Yeah. Because if more than 50% of the country does not participate in the election of the country's most powerful man, then there's a feeling that if they never participated in that exercise, then there's a question about the legitimacy of the process that produced that very powerful man for the country. How do you make these people feel that they are part of the country, and in light of the political tensions that you would say is at a fever pitch now?
First, we really don't know the numbers finally that will have participated until the election. I mean, the results are in, because they are not in, that we don't know. But every part of this country is significant. There is no part that is not important. So every Kenyan will have to be included. Probably the government will look at the statistics and then look at the policy. The policy that may have produced the differences, and try to address those policy issues so that Kenyans can feel included. Because there is no part that is not important here. Every part of this republic is important to all of us. This is like a body organism. And if one part of the body is hurting, then the entire body will hurt. So that, I believe the leaders we have elected through this process, they are very much aware of that. And their assignment and their responsibility is to bring us together as the embryo to the country. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Thank you so much for your time, That's Professor.
Thank you.
Well, Mike, we will be getting you the figures from the constituency returning officers across the 9 constituencies here in Meru County in a few. And of course, we will be keeping this conversation ongoing as we get the final results from the Bomas of Kenya. Back to you, Mike.
Thank